أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. But for the grace of Allah that we are still in existence. And always a reminder for myself from the depth of the reality of La ilaha illallah Muhammadun Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and how we govern our lives from the ocean of tawheed, that we know there's nothing but Allah and the other side is shaitan. There's no in between. It's either coming from divine grace or it comes from a wickedness, a badness, what people feel comfortable calling. You either make a good choice and there are shades of good, or you make a bad choice and then the shades of bad, it can be really bad. So either you're going towards the right or you're going towards the wrong. It's from the tawheed, nothing but Allah, and that we follow the example of Muhammadun Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So when people say, where is this from? This is really from tawheed, where people don't understand tawheed, because for them they have shades of everything. It could be from anyone, oh they were saying that because… and they explain now why they were saying this situation. And I said, yeah, that's how you think things. In our training it all came down to, is this inspired by Allah and I'm moving towards the right, or was this inspired by shaitan? Because we understand that there's a play, our life is a play, and the characters are insignificant for us. So whether the characters have two in that scene, because our life, every moment of our life is a scene. So you're in a situation, you're with somebody, a loved one preferably, because they have all your buttons. So somebody dear to you, a family member to you, and they begin to start saying things that are not correct in your understanding of faith. And so they say because of this, they said because of this, they said because of this. How we view our lives and our understanding on how to govern ourselves, we say, okay, that event, let's take it as just one scene. And in that scene the character is me and that other person. But who's really pulling the strings on that scene?
Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is Shaykh Nurjan, thank you for watching the video that you're watching. InshaAllah, if you're happy with the content and happy with these programs, please support the button below, the programs that we have for our orphanage repairs, our water well, give the gift of life, our mobile food vans. We have now 5 vans, Vancouver, Chicago, Los Angeles, Pakistan. There's many programs that reach thousands of people and rescue foods and give those supplies to people in need. Your support is greatly appreciated. Also, be so kind as to leave loving comments and please share the stream. Every bit counts. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
If an inspiration is coming in that dialogue from Allah, then it has to be to me as something positive, moving towards something positive. Then that scenario in my life, I feel that maybe that was then an isharat, that the guidance of Allah through His Rasul, through the shaykhs, inspired this person to a goodness. That was like an interesting thing, I probably should be incorporating that, and that I take that understanding as a movement towards the direction of completing my faith. There can only be two. Or the dialogue has something to do with shaitan, because it's in the discussion, so I didn't know that like shaitan is with everyone, that every family member, every person can have a shaitan. I said, shaitan came into paradise. There's not a masjid that shaitan's not sitting in and sitting in big time amongst people. there's not a grocery store, there's not a place on earth that shaitan is not accompanying somebody. He leaves no one to themselves. His promise to Allah is that, "I'm going to hit them from six sides." Negative energy hits us from six sides, in front, behind, above, below, to the right, to the left. Six directions of our being is a promise from shaitan, and he doesn't break his promise, "I'm attacking this creation." Allah attack except my mukhlas. So mukhlas have a sense of a shield that they are attacked, but Allah has them to be mahfuz, guarded. That something is coming towards them, they may fall into a difficulty, and then Allah guards them, recalibrates and puts them back into position. And this is Qur'an that Allah said, "Not my mukhlas." So that category is separate. All other than mukhlas, you're guaranteed a six directional attack from this negativity. So then the wise, every scene is a chess game. Why? If you're good at it, you can do it subconsciously as it's happening because you're prepared. I know every scenario and every step of where I'm going to go, how it's going to be confrontational. I have my wudu, I'm washed, I'm ready, I step into a situation, boom, the discussions are going. It's without doubt, it always happens. And they're usually relatives because they have all the buttons. It's not the postman, because we're not psychotic. Your postman doesn't walk by and start screaming weird things to you. It's the family that have all your buttons, want to bring up all these bizarre discussions. And this scene is a test. As a result of that test, I'm in wudu, and when you're more established and experienced, you're playing the chess game in your consciousness. That you're slowing down the scene and saying, "What that person's saying from their mouth? And who's really saying it?" Because the words they're speaking doesn't seem that that would be from Allah, nor His angels, nor His Prophet ﷺ, nor awliya. So it's very easy that those are not isharat, because these are not the words, these are not the understanding. Then this is from who? Shaitan. Shaitan has a hand in everything. We catch it as a continuous consciousness because it's a part of guidance. How could you deal with people if you can't slow the whole situation in your heart and understand what this person is telling you? Because many people come up to you, "Shaykh, I want to talk to you, but everything is fantastic in my life, I'm great." It don't matter what your lips say, we know what you're doing, what you are, what you say. So they have to be good in it for the world of guidance, otherwise could you imagine being a guide and taking what people say from their lips? Allah says, "No, we'll seal their lips." Allah already gave the criteria for governance, that when they enter into the heavens and want to talk, we'll seal their lips, because we don't care for what people say from their mouth. That's a different subject. But as far as understanding life, understanding life scenarios, these are important. Because they say, "Well, I didn't think it was, had something to do with shaitan, I thought this is just discussion and this person is saying this and that person is saying that." I say, "Yeah, but if you think of it as it's not a play and that people are really saying something and want to do this and want to do that, it affects your coordinates and your understanding and you reaching tawheed. Because when you want to reach to tawheed, everything is a scenario. Is this pushing me towards Allah, this moment, this test, this very second, or is this having to do with shaitan? And the shaitan trying to take me off my course?" If we can catch those scenarios and not be lost in the excitement of the scene. Because people play the scene out and go through all the emotions and, "Oh my God, what is your..." and get lost in the scene, get lost in the drama of that scene, and they never step back like a chess game, that what does Allah want from this scenario? Why is this happening? Why did this person say this? who's actually saying and where they're trying to move my direction. Very few people even understand that, really grasp that. Fewer will try to catch it. Most are lost in the scene. They begin the battle, the yelling, the screaming, being upset that why this person said, why that person said this. And tariqah is all about tafakkur, to contemplate. So you sit, then all of a sudden you go into a scenario, some people say, give it like an example, you go to a scenario, it's a family event, and the person who you know always has something to say that, why you have to look like this? And why does it have to always be so extreme, your belief system? And get a whole discussion, whether why you have to wear this hat, why you have this beard? This all seems to you like it's a discussion that we should be having, okay, this is discussion. But for the conscious observer, is that before you get trapped into an argument and a discussion, and I'm going to change the opinion of this person, subconsciously you pull back a second and say, this is not going to be coming from Allah.
Eastern cultures use teas and herbs as an elixir of health and wellness. Rumi Rose Teas revives this ancient tradition with a collection of over 40 delicious hand-blended teas. Enjoy God-given health and wellness within every cup of Rumi Rose Tea. Order online now. A Timeless Reality with Sheikh Nurjan Mirahmidi guides the reader in meditation, connecting the heart to a guide and to daily spiritual practices to understand the effects of positive and negative energy and to progress the reader in their spiritual awakening and the soul's connection to the world of light. The Divine's Ancient Timeless Reality. Order on Amazon.com.
Allah says what? We don't change the condition of a person until they change themselves. That's the same thing of escaping from an insane asylum. They don't let you check out because you keep failing and doing the same thing every day and something different is going to happen. They say, every time I cross this road I get hit by a car. And every day I cross the same place, well every day you're going to get hit by a car. Until one time the aql opens, the heart opens and says, maybe I should not be crossing from here that the car keeps hitting me. Tariqah then comes and says, slow the situation down like a chess game. That you wash, you put your taweez, a dialogue is happening, you know that when you enter into that scenario this event is going to begin. How are you prepared for it? The minute somebody starts to speak, you know, is this coming from Allah? MashaAllah, this is great, this is beautiful, I love what you're doing, you're purifying yourself. Alhamdulillah, you left the desires for dunya, you're doing your zikr, you're doing your awrads. So this is a ishara from Allah, MashaAllah, somebody's happy up there. But it's the other side, why you look like that? You have to do all that. Would Allah tell you not to do zikr? Would Allah tell you why you have to make tasbih? No, it doesn't take a rocket scientist to understand. So then in your heart you're slowing down, okay. So now this is not between me and that person and that relative, this is about me and shaitan that's behind that person. So you went to the core of the problem now, it's not the characters in this movie. It's the other problems. So when I take the characters out and now I want to deal with how shaitan is coming at me. If I understood that in life, then I just stay quiet. I'm not going to convert shaitan. He's well, way too advanced to fall into a discussion. And you know you fell when you start to engage with shaitan because now he's got you. You don't conquer him, You will not conquer him. You'll be the only person in creation that was able to conquer him. Allah's reward was a'udhu billah. Disengage. Allah never gave you go after him and argue with shaitan. He said, seek refuge in me from shaitan. So in your heart, a'udhu billahi min shaitan. And you stay quiet. Means you put your reality and you went back into Allah, that my faith and trust in Allah, my dominion is not to now come out and deal with shaitan. If we can do that enough times, we become sincere. We're not becoming agitated because shaitan wants to agitate you. He wins when you become angered, riled up. Two, three words, you're now in an anger, you're in an argument. It's not a righteous argument because it started off with shaitan. There's nothing righteous at all. It's just going to be satanic, more and more aggression, bad character. And now your rank is going down instead of going up, you're getting check marks off, and that's how he's winning. Oh, look, I thought he's a very patient guy, he's yelling now. I thought he doesn't have anger, now he's turning red. And that's how he's winning, he's happy, he's like check, 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 until you leave that house fully defeated. And so sad and so upset because you spent the whole week to build yourself, or a month to build yourself, or a day to build yourself. That's what it means to struggle. Struggle thinking what? That you're going to go down the street, there's somebody with horns on the corner and he's coming after you with a pitchfork. No, it's all the people we love. And that evilness coming and whispering and pushing through them to see what type of character you're going to have, what type of reaction you're going to have. And this is our whole life. Our whole life is about identifying every scene. Why is it happening? And the conscious and my consciousness that what's this scenario? I'm to be patient in this scenario. And then I train myself to drown out sound and noise. Means everything and everything coming to a believer is a test. If you think for a moment you're test free, you failed that moment. There's not a second or a millisecond in which God is heedless of you and that you're not under a test and that your reaction is not being watched and that your interaction is not being observed. So then to reach towards sincerity and to achievement, and that's why Prophet ﷺ described it as an immense struggle, jihadul akbar. Jihad is a fight and akbar means great, huge fight. And he described the greatest fight is the one who fights himself. And that's why it's such a difficult process. To stop at every scenario that why this person said that? And then how is this going to be affecting me? Not the why that to come after you, but the why of what shaitan is trying to do to me. How is he trying to defeat me? How is he trying to get me to be angered? How is he trying to bring my station down? So it's not about the people. We hold all the characters to be harmless. Because Allah's testing me. Allah allowed shaitan to enter into that scene and now to make everything to be exciting, spicy. The one whom is able to meditate, contemplate and struggle against themselves. They catch every dialogue and in their heart they analyze that dialogue. Is this drawing me to the Divine? Then alhamdulillah. If it's not, and it's of negativity, there's no need to go further into this. And that's why Sufis don't fight. They don't yell and scream at a place. They actually stay quiet and move away and say, oh, where are you guys, where are you running to? So, there's nothing to do with me. We're not here to play with shaitan, we're here to make Rahman happy and to achieve God's satisfaction. For if enough times he's happy, then you'll be granted and crowned with sincerity, that you sincerely struggle against yourself. Not that you're enormously victorious, but you're able to identify how this is coming, identify how shaitan is attacking you, and then Allah begin to grant the servants sincerity and they move towards being mukhlis. When they become mukhlis, Allah guards them. They become mahfuz, guarded, in which lots of inspirations come to them. And as a result, as soon as they enter into a room, the angels are whispering that shaitan is coming after you. Remain silent. Means there's a lot of tools at Allah's disposal to begin to guide and help the servant. We pray that we give an understanding to ourselves on this scenario and this understanding. Because this loved one was very astonished, oh, shaitan's everywhere, thinking that, you know, there's only a time when we're battling shaitan. I said, no, our battle with shaitan is at every moment. If you think that shaitan taking a break for a millisecond, then something is wrong in the aqeedah and the belief of that person. That fight is a continuous fight. He's not happy at all of what you're achieving, nor is he interested in you achieving, and every time you achieve, he goes down in his achievement. And if you reach close enough, can you play a game to lose? Because it's chess or put checkers. Every time you're getting close to the target, you're going to be crowned. Huh? If your king reaches the other side, you get it to be a crowned special king that can move like the queen. You know why the queen is so powerful that moves everywhere? The king can only move one space at a time. But if you move all the way to that and you'll be crowned. You think shaitan sits there and lets you play, please go right here, crown yourself. No, because then you become much more difficult to deal with. Every time you become powerful, you become much more difficult to deal with. So the game's on, he doesn't take a break. It's a matter of us is leaving our heedlessness, where we become heedless every moment. Oh yeah, you're right, he is attacking. Means then we put our notes, we put our post-it notes, and that my fight with evilness is a continuous fight. At every moment it's approaching me. And at every scenario I have to have a consciousness, and as soon as I become good at it, I can slow a scene down in my heart and begin to analyze right away that this is not going to go in the direction that makes Allah happy. This is going to go into something that defeats me and brings me down, get angered, to be in a bad situation. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun, wa salaamun al mursaleen, walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, bi hurmati Muhammad al Mustafa, wa bi siri Surat al Fatiha.
If money could just grow on trees, there would be no need for this message. Since it doesn't, let us show you where your generous donations are going. We film, edit, and produce weekly television shows of Divinely Knowledge throughout Canada and the UK, as well as live stream internationally on Facebook and YouTube. Sheikh Nurjan's ever-growing online presence is the result of continuous financial input, and with your financial assistance and participation, this rapid growth will continue. Our Muhammadan Way app is continuously being upgraded and improved, providing an all-encompassing Islamic guide. In addition to the Muhammadan Way app, nurmuhammad.com is a website of immense knowledge and comprehensive Islamic teachings that is updated daily. Your ongoing support also enables a team of editors to compile books of heavenly wisdom from Sheikh Nurjan's teachings. one of our longest ongoing initiatives has been to provide basic necessities to the most in need worldwide. From feeding people in Vancouver's downtown east side, to clothing LA's homeless community, and supporting a children's orphanage in Pakistan. Your ongoing donations will help us continue to spread the love and example of the Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him. Become a shareholder in immense blessings. NurMuhammad.com/donate.